Alright, welcome back to our FTL challenge run. We're past the challenging part of the game, where we had to upgrade our sensors to level 3, and then dive every single sector exit, so now all we've got to do is take this home. There's a small matter of the flagship, but there is also Sector 8, and you've got these stowaways on board. Yeah, you cut that out. We're not in the business of transporting rebels to the front lines here. You get my drift. So, funnily enough, this is actually probably going to come down to resource management, which is a little bit unusual. Usually for me, either if I get to Sector 8 and I have any problems at all, it's either that I feel too weak to properly take on the flagship, or I feel fine with the flagship and I feel too weak to properly take on the Sector 8 enemies. But I don't really feel either of those. Right now, it's honestly the drones that I'm most worried about. I'd say that would be how I would be most likely to lose the game, is running out of drone parts and not being able to hack all three phases of the flagship. Now, of course, there is an easy way to remedy that, which would be to not hack anybody, but that would probably mean I would not be able to get as much scrap as I would like from this sector, and given the history of this run, I kind of still feel like I would like more scrap. I could probably beat the flagship with my ship the way it is, but having more upgrades would absolutely not hurt. And that is what Sector 8 is there to help provide us. Luckily, it seems the game is being merciful, and it will give us a whole top-off, which we don't need, and drones, which we absolutely do need. So, there you have it. But I was certainly looking forward to a Sector 8 where these five drone parts were not available for my benefit. Okay, cool. Let's upgrade our ship. What do we desperately need? I think we need level 2 doors. We kind of need more power, sure, but I think we need level 2 doors purely because it'll help mitigate ion intruders. Something to always keep in mind for Sector 8. That can get nasty in a hurry, especially with the complement of other things a rebel rigger can have on hand, such as hacking or attack drones. But otherwise, I don't think I'm too worried about Rebel fighters should be a joke at this point. Auto ships will be a little bit more of a headache because our fire beam won't work on them, but we have hacking level 3, halberd beam, dual lasers, ion stunner. We should be okay for those. So most of the time we should be okay. It's just a ship like this that'll give me a brief pause. But this one doesn't look that bad. Alright, I saw that. They are firing off some kind of a boarding drone. So they've got they've got 4 power in this and this. They've got 1 power for that, so they've got a 3 power boarding drone, which doesn't tell us anything because both of them are 3 power anyway. But they do have relatively low engines and pretty much standard autopilot at this point. Otherwise, nothing particularly impressive. So we'll go ahead and man the doors to slow that guy down. Try and do the bypass trick here. And cloak the missile, and life ought to be good. And we can probably slow this guy down enough for this to not be an issue. Now, we don't have level 2 oxygen, but the boarding drone is by far the more benign of the two options. For sure. No doubt about that. In fact, we don't even need level 3 shields at the moment. Level 2 will be fine while this thing is spooling up. And hopefully they should be very dead before that gets a chance. I'm more worried about this missile, really. Okay, so we cloak the first missile for the maximum amount of time that we can. Don't need those shields, so we'll keep the oxygen on to keep the air in that room as long as we can. Dodge the missile, don't need engines anymore, so we can turn those back off. And go to town. So that's certainly one benefit of the fire beam, is it's going to make it harder for the system repair drone to do its job. And what? How do I want to arrange this? I definitely want two fires in there, and fires in the shield room. So something like this ought to work, just barely. Yeah, there we go. Two fires there, two fires there, and a bonus fire. Great. And you guys still have air. Great. Also good. So yeah, that's basically perfect. I ionized the weapons room to turn off the missile, and it's on fire, and the guy in there is stunned. Two fires in a hacked room, the repair drone is locked out, and nobody is trying to fix the fire in piloting. Beautiful. Now, I did kind of utterly wreck their ship with their Halberd Beam, so I'm not going to be able to go for the crew kill, but honestly, going for a crew kill on a ship with a missile is probably a little bit optimistic at this point, and the scrap is just good anyway. And we can repair all zero of that damage we took. Yeah, how about you repair that hole in the floor for us? Alright, that's better, and we're even gonna have the Sector 8 store on top of that. I mean, sure, why not? Do we have anything to sell? No. So, I think I'll handle this by going to the repair beacon, and then if the store is still there, then I'll go to it. I'd like to buy something other than just one crewman, but if that's what they've got, then that's what they've got. Alright, that's a more acceptable amount of money. On the other hand, I could just ignore it. That is a beacon that won't give me scrap. So I could just become more powerful in other ways. Five crew ought to be enough if I'm not taking much damage. And hacking and a fire beam should certainly kill a lot of the crew on the flagship, if not necessarily all of it. So about how many jumps can I expect? Well, probably only three. And maybe not even that. Maybe only two. And one of them could be empty. So I'll say about two jumps. So that'll be about something on the order of 50 scrap, maybe 60 or 70 if we're lucky. If we're really super lucky, it could be a lot more than that, but let's say it's about 40. So that's 130 scrap. What do we do with that money? We don't need weapons buffer. That's very expensive for questionable benefit. If I lose the ion stunner, it's not a huge deal. Don't need more mind control. Oxygen, we don't really need either. I'd say piloting is good at this point. Yeah, piloting is good, and then more power to run things smoother. I don't think we're going to be able to get level 4 shields unless we get a lot of money. That's what I was trying to figure out. So I think we're just going to skip on that. Engines level 5 is in perhaps good, but probably not really in practice. And I think we just want more power, right? Yeah, we'll decide what we want to use it for later, but I think for right now we just want it. Yeah. To run the shield smoother, if nothing else. Alright, but let us be optimistic and proceed as though we will get 3 beacons, and one of them will be a double reward, and we'll get, like, 200 scrap. It's a good start. Should be pretty standard here. Now that I don't have to worry about drone parts at all, everything is good. I don't need any extra data here. Nope. Nope, you get on doors. Slow them down. Alright, so now I can run all of this at the same time, which is great. And then next we'll get a system bar and something or another. One thing or some other thing. I probably want 2 fires and shields and 3 in weapons. That's usually a good balance. Acceptable. Now, if I can just get this missile turned off, then we should be in business. We can maybe get a crew kill here. Yeah, there we go. Good. Shields will be down soon. We can set the rest of the ship on fire. The nice thing about Rebel fighters in Sector 8 is that they've got plenty of hull. Which is, you know, sounds scary, but in practice it usually isn't if your weapons are up to the job by now. And it just makes fire strategies easier to do. Because you're not going to be blowing up the ship by accident. I don't know. There's a couple of tiles that aren't on fire yet. We ought to be able to fix that right up, though. Yeah, let's get a level 4 sensor readout of this thoroughly on fire ship. We're not gonna quite get every tile on fire, but it's close enough. Alright, 77 scrap for a crew kill in Sector 8, and, you know, low fuel and drone part, but thankfully we don't need to worry about that anymore. And 26 more scrap. Sure. Okay, I guess we'll just make, over 100 scrap in one beacon, like I was alluding to. Sure. And we even haven't gotten either of these taken over yet. Okay, well, do I want to get slightly greedy and maybe go for level 4 shields? I would say that gives us the most, that is the most survivability you can get in, like, one pair of upgrades. And even the half upgrade is alright. Missile to the shields, like, if a missile lands on the shields and lights on fire, it's nice to have level 3 shields for the duration. So, I'll go with that. Alright, let's see how much more money the universe is willing to give us. And then, take it to the final ship. Oh, this is a regular old event. It's a filler event. We will, of course, be attacking this ship. There is nothing he could sell us that we want to purchase. And we'll be fighting a level, like, a Sector 8 pirate, which can be, honestly, one of the most dangerous ships in the game. But, thankfully this one is, pretty benign. Alright, you cut that out. Yeah. So that's, honestly, all of this stuff is nearly capped, I think. Maybe the mind control or the clone bay could go a little bit higher, but you can see that he's got 4 weapons and he's even struggling to fill all that out. Just happened to roll low on all of his weapons choices here, with a heavy laser 1 and a basic laser, I suppose. Thankfully, neither of those are burst laser 2, or this might be a different story. We'll save it. We're in no rush. And we'll get our pilot to remember to be a good pilot again. Okay, that's more like it. And with a careful attention to detail, we should be able to crew kill these guys as well. Thankfully, they don't really know how to use their lasers, and even if they did, we could cloak them anyway. Alright, so we're not going to go for maximum damage here this time. Honestly, we just really want to hit... Well, we want to hit weapons and clone bay, I guess, but... We'll hit shields anyway, just to keep them distracted, so I guess we're just going to do this 6 damage shot and call that good enough. Yeah, satisfactory, I suppose. And now that their mind control is turned off, we can use ours when the time comes. But they are far too distracted to deal with any of this. 2 crew, no airlocks, fire beam is gonna mess you up. That's just how it goes. Nope, you do not actually get to repair that. You actually get to damage that. Something like that ought to work. Yeah, there we go. I want to make sure I clip the corner of the piloting room here. Just for efficiency's sake. Yep, and get all three of those squares lit on fire, so... Didn't get the extra fire in the shields room, but we hit the important parts of the ship on fire anyway, and they've got plenty of hull, so life is good. No, we are past accepting those types of surrenders. You ought to give us, all the weapons on your ship. Then maybe we'll let you live. If you can even manage that. No, I'm sorry. That's just how, pirates go. You know, sometimes you get to make fun of, weak civilians, but every now and then you run into a true hero who, lights your entire ship on fire and, roasts you to death. No, I'm sorry. Pirates are just acceptable targets in the FTL universe. For target practice, or for jokes. Well, I'm sorry to say that this pirate is not going to be walking into any bars. ...73 scrap, and a drone part. Sure. Yeah. Give us something to do with that money. And we're even going to get the third beacon. Cool. Well, that is far more money than I thought I was going to be getting with those jumps. And we're going to get some here, too. Probably not that much. Auto-ship fights like this usually don't give that much, but it's better than nothing. Be slightly stronger for the flagship, as one does. We could certainly use 2 more power now that we've got an extra thing to put 2 more power in. Although the battery ought to be good enough for the most part. Don't really need to wait on the fire beam here. In fact, I guess we'll reorder the weapons like that. Just to be conscientious, not that I think we're going to be taking any damage, but it's good to think about such things. That's probably an ion bomb. I am not going to wait around to find out. Alright, let us... Well, I don't even care about the mind control, so we'll hit engines. And we have the fire beam, so we might as well use it, I guess. Slow down the repairs just a teeny tiny bit. Yeah, it is still totally cheating that they can mind control you while you're cloaked, though, because you can't mind control enemy crewmen if they're cloaked and you don't have vision of their ship. That is one thing I wish that the game was a little bit better about tracking, was visibility status. But so be it. Maybe someday a spiritual successor could come along and handle that problem a little bit more elegantly. And 49 scrap, that's honestly better than I thought for that kind of a fight. Alright, so is this it? Are we at the eve of taking on the flagship? We are indeed. In fact, we're even going to get the benefit of being able to jump away and jump back if we really want to. Which we might, depending upon what they hack. I'd probably do that if they hack my shields or my weapons. Anything else, I probably don't even care. We're going to be killing them too fast for the oxygen hack to be a problem. But, let's find out. Let's find out what they're hacking. What have we got? Let's charge up the engines as fast as possible, I guess. Weapons. That's no good. I don't like that. It's not the worst thing in the world, especially since it's the first hack that landed on my weapons, and not, like, a subsequent hack if I were shooting some of them down. So it will line up with their cloak and not be impossible. I will get to fire the Halberd Beam and the Fire Beam in this case, but there's no real reason to let them do that, so... Odds are if I jump away and jump back, they will probably not hack weapons. It could still happen, but there's no consecutive, like, guarantees here. I think it's just a random roll each time, independent, through and through. But, we'll roll the dice. They could certainly hack doors or sensors next time. Or shields. They could just make life worse, but most of the time it's better, I think. So yeah, we'll just get out of here. We'll let our cloak cool down as much as we can, and we'll check see where we're going. Yes, in fact, we'll even get another beacon this way. So, I'd honestly prefer to stick it out and fight if I could, but, you know, because the option's open to us, we might as well take it, I guess is what I'm saying. If they hacked something that was safe, I would just go ahead and take it, but... Oh, that's a little rude. Don't do that, Flagship. Don't be that way. And as soon as the next set of missiles comes in, we'll be out of here. Not even gonna waste the drone part. I could hack their hacking, but that's just a waste compared to... trying to ensure that they don't, well, hack something important, and then have it for you to hack the shields. Alright, we're not sticking around. See you later, Flagship. Just a moment. And because I waited this long, now my cloaking will be ready for whatever nonsense this ship has for me. Which is gonna be mostly defensive stuff, it looks like. Yeah. Thankfully, they don't have a boarding drone on top of that, but hacking at a missile could be quite annoying. What are you hacking this time? Shields. Could be a lot worse. Thankfully, they've got all the defensive drones, so I'm not... actually, you know what? You just stay in there, just in case you have to repair that. And you're not really doing anything important either, so you also getting shields. Alright, otherwise business as usual, although the shield overcharger will make this a little bit more of a hassle, but not really that much more. I've got the weapons and tools to deal with that. Get rid of that. Or, well, maybe not, if both those miss, but... Tell you what... Oh, wait. Hmm. Did it miss? It must have missed, I guess. Or had trouble, figuring out what it was going to shoot at, I guess. Yeah, we're already ready. You go back over here, cloak the missile. Put permanent power into mind control, and prepare to destroy. We'll have to get rid of that. Honestly, I probably should have mind controlled before that happened, but yeah, especially with the shield room blocked, but that's okay. Alright. Want that to be damaged. Want this to be thoroughly lit on fire. And we want to stun the people working in there, although it's going to shoot that down anyway. But maybe it won't. Maybe if it gets turned off, it won't. Alright, it won't. Cool. Alright, good. I'd say we've got this pretty well in hand. Don't have anything to fear from their shield hack now. Wow, that's a lot of hole to be running away at, actually. Yeah, tell you what, I'm gonna do two damage. One to the weapons, just to help make sure this stays off, and one to the shields to speed this up a bit. I think their ship can probably take that. Okay, good. They don't have drones anymore. You just get back on sensors, I guess. Well, you start getting out of there. To here, and then you get on sensors. They're not gonna have shields soon. Okay, what needs to be on fire that is not currently on fire? Good question. Honestly, I guess oxygen. Otherwise, I'm pretty happy with this the way it is. I probably could have lit weapons on fire. So we've got that much time before engines burns down, and, well, okay, they still have the one hole, though. Okay, so what do we mind control, then? Weapons, I think? Yeah, weapons. Good, so he'll kill him, and then we just try and burn this guy as best we can. Would one laser shot do it? One single laser shot would do it. Alright, one single laser shot will do it. 58 scrap. Cool. So now we're even better armed and ready for the flagship. So I think we've got enough power. Pretty much, yeah. We're gonna use the battery for probably the engines mostly. Otherwise we're one power short, so I guess we could buy one power and maybe engines after that. And then we'd have four shields and five engines in. That's probably overdoing it a little bit, and we'd be fine. Right, but we do need to go back right away. But we've got time to do this first. In fact, that's 75 scraps, so we can just do both of them. Okay. We'll do then. Alright, let's roast us a flagship. Okay, hack something more polite this time, please. Clone Bay. Acceptable. Very much so. Alright, sadly they have cottoned on to our level 4 sensors power play this time, so we're not going to be allowed to use that on the flagship. But thankfully for us, we don't really need them for this fight either. Because we already know what we're fighting. The flagship is the one constant in any run, and there are mods to mess with that, but in the vanilla game, what you see is what you get. The only random parts is what they target and what they hack. And their the composition of their phase 2 drone surge. So yeah, power distribution is gonna look something like this. Yeah. Alright, now the fire beam is really gonna do a number on these guys, because the one of their main weaknesses is just the bottleneck that hacking the shields room does to them. So they're gonna have a tremendously bad time repairing anything. So, we kind of skipped the hard part of having a fire beam run. We basically just had this handed to us in the last part of the game, which I appreciate. It certainly makes this specific fight easier, if nothing else. Alright, dual lasers to turn that off. We'll hold the ion stunner. Mind control you. And follow that up with a fire beam. I just want the maximum number of fires in here, honestly, so probably something like that will do. 3 fires in the shields room, 1 fire in the missile room, and 1 fire in piloting. And we want to ion stun the people working in the shields room. Okay, cool. And we got... Actually, we got 6 out of 6 fires. That's actually amazing. I was not expecting that at all. Good work, Firebeam. Highest quality Firebeam. A+. Would Firebeam again. So with 4 fires in the shield room and the room hacked, some of them might escape to heal up, but their crew is absolutely doomed in the long run. There's not any way they can really deal with this. They might incidentally be able to put out some fires in the missile room or in this empty hallway, but they just cannot deal with 4 fires in the shield room and the room being hacked. They just can't. They do not have the tools for it. So, we should be able to draw this fight out a little bit. Yeah, you can see it. They're just, they're dying by the truckload here. Don't even really need to do that much more hull damage. I just want to make sure they don't do anything saucy like get too much of that missile repaired there. In fact, we're probably better off setting these rooms on fire. Try and get 2 fires in the missile room and light the rooms on fire that are adjacent to the hacked doors. There we go, 2 fires in the missile room. And 2 fires in that room for good measure. And due to the way that they just have to stay in that room while beating down the doors, that'll get some extra crew damage in quite nicely. What do I want to ion stunner? I guess these guys. Again, it bears mentioning, they do not have any shields at this point. Right, so I'd only need 1 power in here. That frees up power for the rest of this, and I can cloak anytime I feel threatened, which honestly now is pretty good. I know they're in no danger of beaming me, but at the very least, let's make sure you don't get hit by this laser, I guess. Cool. And the rest is just waiting patiently and seeing how many of their crew die. They're not in any danger of doing hull damage to me at the moment. So it's pretty much just trying to do my best to mess with them. And if I don't kill off all the crew, that's fine. Just as long as I get most of them. Yeah, I've definitely gotten most of them. I think they've only got 2 crew left, in fact. Oh, look, one of you isn't actually helping anymore. He's also shooting that guy. Alright, so he'll go somewhere else and be generally unhelpful. We'll even start lighting this stuff on fire too, sure. And there, they only have one crewman left in the main cabin. And they've got plenty of hull still. Their large amount of hull is working against them. I'll even do this, just to speed this up a little bit. Because this is going on long enough, I think we can all agree. Are hacking. And you have exactly enough health that I can kill you with one laser. If you had 15, I probably couldn't do it, but with 14, I am guaranteed that this will work. So we'll go ahead and let that animation complete, so I can be absolutely sure that he's dead, and then we'll do a nice aesthetic cut down the right side of the ship. Hey, I cut the right half of the ship off. Why'd the left wing blow up? That's one of the mysteries of FTL. Anyway, phase one is the hard phase if you have a fire beam build. Now that all of their crew are dead, the rest ought to be trivial. I don't even need to, do the, wait at the base for phase two and then engage phase three away from the base strategy because I don't have to kidnap any crew. All the crew are dead. The only crew who isn't is this guy in the Halberd Beam room, and despite his animation, he doesn't actually do anything. That's a artillery room, not a weapons room. So he can't provide any weapons manning bonus to that. So he is utterly useless other than for repairing the beam weapon, and the beam weapon is absolutely not my main concern at the moment. It is just getting through this phase with the minimum of incident, which I should be able to do. I should be able to save my cloaking. Halberd Beam does go off before the first missile strike, so otherwise I should be able to cloak either missiles or drones or both. And now that they don't have any crew, the fire beam is guaranteed to do damage eventually, because there's nobody to put it out. So that's how that goes. Let's see. Yeah, this, and then, well, this. There's nobody to ion stun anymore. And then, what do I want to fire beam? I guess shields and lasers, why not? Alright, so, in fact, I don't even have to cloak the missiles because they're off. So they're just not gonna fire straight up. You get on shields, not that you're gonna be necessary on there, but you can do it. You help out a little bit and then get back on there. You might have to abandon the room soon, but that's alright. I have, after all, a sensors buffer, to end all sensors buffers. And we can go ahead and cloak the drone swarm. 100% effective. And there go their lasers. The beam is not much of a threat on its own. It can be, but it just often isn't. Let's just make sure they don't fire another boarding drone in on us. And fix up that hole, and we're good to go. So everyone on my own ship is only mostly dead, otherwise they're fine. And we can basically do whatever we want. Although the last, this last drone surge might actually be a problem, come to think of it. But I did turn off their lasers. Also, I think I shot one of their regular drones, so they just decided to, launch another boarding drone, just to pay a visit. In any case, I think our cloaking is coming up fast enough, and our beam will be ready fast enough that, they should not damage us. Alright, let me get my ship cleaned up, and I will be right back to you. Oh, well, first we gotta do this, though. Always remember to spend your money after phases 1 and 2 of the flagship. You do get a little tiny bit more money, so it could come in handy for something or other. In this case, I guess... Like, mind control level 2 wouldn't hurt, but at the same time, there's no crew to worry about, so I think I'm just gonna pick up one more power. And leave it at that. And clone my crew. Alright, good. I think we're basically ready to go. Not much else we can do about this. Okay, so... They are out of crew, so this will be an AI flagship, but honestly, that's not so bad. It just means that they get a slight bit of auto repair to their systems, just like a regular auto ship. And the fire beam is not a weapon that this particular auto ship can handle, because it can't put them out, and it's not smart enough to turn off its oxygen, so it'll just let any fires burn. But in the meantime, while we gotta carve through this, this thing at full evasion... the fire beam's not gonna be doing us that much good, so that might as well be the thing to turn off if we get damaged. We don't have anything better to do with our mind control than just unmind control that guy. We could allow them to do 2 points of system damage, but it's the sensors. We could never let the sensors get damaged. You know, it was bad enough that they put a hole in them in the prior phase, they've jammed them, so clearly the flagship fears our sensors, so we have to keep them online. For any extra psychological benefit we can get against this unthinking, uncaring, unfeeling machine. And now the eternal question. Do I try the level 3 cloak against the incoming missiles to be greedy, try and cloak that and the power surge? Or do I just take them on the chin and, save it for the power surge? I've got 4 shields and 5 engines, that's usually pretty good, so... I think we're more likely to take, we take a higher expected amount of damage from the missiles now than we do the power surge. Nevertheless, I will try and be super greedy about this and wait until the last second. Alright, close enough. Alright, what have we got? Alright, thankfully the fire beam can contribute a little bit here. Alright. 2 points. It's not great, but it's better than nothing. Cut that out. And we might have done that a little bit early, but that's fine. If we do it early, it's okay, and at the very least, it desynchronizes this, laser shot from that, so... Yeah, the timing on that is a little bit random. Can't always, fix that. We'll just do some expert-level dodging instead, not even go down to 0 shields. It's fine. So sadly, we didn't quite crack the Zoltan shield fast enough, so we'll be taking this set of missiles on the face. Nothing we can do about that. We'll get a little bit greedy and... Oh. I think this is already firing. Yeah, it's already firing, so... We'll go ahead and let that fire. Okay. We'll launch the hacking. We'll use regular power to do it, not battery power, in case we get hit in the battery. And otherwise, do the best we can. Alright, two misses. That's very solid. And one hit to an empty room and no fire. Pretty much the best result you can expect, just taking that straight up. I have gotten three misses in a row on these, but it is very rare. In any case, they're super vulnerable now. I'm gonna hit them hard. We will be subject to that, but we can cloak it now this time, and we can light the light everything on fire, nice and cozy. We do want the shield room taken out as much as possible, though. We'll do a one power cloak this time. Try and line it up. Good. Alright, didn't quite cloak all of that, but we cloaked enough of it that we were fine. So, we're good. I'd say it's pretty much good game from this point onward. Not that I was that scared of anything, but, there you have it. So, one damage flagship, pretty common. You need some special dispensation to avoid damage from phase 3, but, one damage is about, well, hell, it's pretty simple. It's the second best you can do compared to taking zero damage. That's how the flagship boils down. We've got killing this thing down to a science. You know, the hard part was just making it here in the first place. Cool, so that was a pretty hard Sector 4 and Sector 5, but after that we hit some kind of magical tipping point where our hacking and our Halberd Beam and our weapons were actually enough to destroy ships, and from there we, well, we just kept getting stronger and stronger from that point onwards. Probably spurred by me, taking a break from the game. 57-57, how funny. Alright. Yeah, 45 ships defeated, lots of beacons explored, as you would expect from a challenge like this one. Not quite my record, but pretty close. And a decent amount of scrap collected, honestly. Considering we had to run away from quite a few fights, also putting a dent in this number, we did alright. Like, there are a lot of points in this game where we could have just straight up died, and we just didn't. And here's my other scores for reference, as well as a partial spoiler for that other ship pack I'm planning on playing at some point. There's a reason why your score gets to be that high. Anyway, yeah, cool. So I'm glad I finished this run out. It's a tough challenge run. I only cheated at one point where I didn't dive for one sector where I wouldn't have gotten much benefit out of diving anyway. But I would absolutely say the hardest part of this challenge is spending the 40 scrap on your sensors and not getting any benefit from it afterwards. That puts you behind for the whole game. Diving in Sector 1 is probably the second worst part of it. Like, that can be completely awful. But sometimes it isn't. But certainly the combination of the two, just being 40 scrap behind for getting ready for that Sector 1 dive, is extremely mean. But I think it's a reasonable challenge, at least on hard mode. On normal mode, I'd say it's a lot more doable. Like, I think you're gonna have a much higher success rate on that just because your Sector 2 is gonna be so much easier. It's, like, gonna be night and day. But it'll make even normal mode pretty hard. But hard mode, you've gotta budget your scrap, and I probably would've come out okay that game, even if it didn't show me quite as much generosity with the free weapons, but I definitely needed something or other. Like, I think you probably need a free weapon. I'm not sure if it necessarily has to be a great one, but I think a free burst laser one will go a long way to making this challenge easier to complete. That's just how far behind that 40 scrap. Like, it's just, even if you get a few free blue options for it, you're still in lousy shape because you still have the useless Sensors 3 instead of something better. Alright, well, that's it for this project. I'll try and probably do some FTL projects some other time, but We'll see. I'm gonna have to figure out how to schedule my time. But I'll try and see if I can do something to keep you guys all interested. So, whatever I end up doing next, I'll see you later.